lot of sunshine, a little rain, growing goodness.
My name is Mark Turner.
My name is Matt Houston, and I'm the general manager.
So we were talking about the materials that existed in the restaurant before we got here, and the floors clearly were here, as well as the ceilings, which again are important. Why dump all of this wood if it's already here? The chairs and the countertops, as well as the wood on the bar, the wood behind the bar, all of the woods over here, they are made out of, this wood in particular is made out of reclaimed barn wood. These are reclaimed oak. All of the woods used inside of our booths are formaldehyde-free woods so that they will break down whenever they go into the ground much more easily.
We became interested in becoming a surfrider ocean-friendly restaurant because honestly it was a natural fit. These were goals that we already had in mind, things we've always been trying to do since we started the business, and a group to support us and to help us vet. Which for me at least is the hardest part of being sustainable, is all the information that's out there, kind of compiling it, bringing it together, and making sure you're using the best practices to, impact the environment in the least negative way and hopefully be a positive part of the environment, actually. Ocean-friendly practices that we were already doing, always using recyclable, compostable to-go-ware. We do a lot of to-go business. Obviously, it can be very wasteful with to-go business. So being extra conscious about what we're using when that to-go-ware is leaving our facility, making sure that it can be recycled. One big thing I know Surfrider helped us with is some of the items we thought were compostable were not actually compostable to the level that we expected. And Surfrider actually helped us vet that information, and we now have new compostable silverware, which is great. And again, that's about, the amount of information and certifications that are out there for, recyclables. There's a lot. One item they pointed out to us is all of our light bulbs in the facility. They're not LED, so we're actually converting all the lights in the facility to LED, which is great. It's going to obviously help our bottom line as well, because that's going to save us some money. But also, obviously, we're not using as much energy, so that goes a long way as well. Restaurants are very wasteful, so being conscious of that waste, it's very hard not to waste, even just wasting food. So being conscious where that food's going, not just throwing it away. The city of Santa Monica thankfully has a great composting program, so we take full advantage of that. Literally almost 80% of our trash is compostable at this point. All the paper we use for the food is compostable. Obviously all the leftover food is compostable itself. The other 10% or 20% is broken down between recyclables. And unfortunately, that last 10% is stuff that can't be recycled and has to be just thrown away in the trash. But that's a pretty low number for a restaurant. We're pretty proud of that. The other challenge I think most people face with being wasteful is just the amount of information that's out there. Similar to the silverware problem that we had, we thought we were doing the right thing. But I think a certification and an endorsement by a company like you guys really helps us. Yeah, we're all very busy. We don't have time to vet every single company, everything we use. We just want to know that they're the right product, and to save us some time in order to do that would help a lot.
So if I were to give any advice to any of you eco-friendly restaurants out there who are trying to expand into different markets or different sides of the country, the thing that I want to encourage everyone to do is don't be afraid of being local. Meaning not every single thing in the restaurant has to be exactly the same from one coast to the other. If you're able and there's an item that you can source at the local farmers market in the West Coast versus the East Coast where you're maybe using the vendors that you are used to using, it's okay because you're a local business. So you need to support your local farmers, you need to support your local community groups, and if anything, I think it adds to the charm of where you are because the lettuce should taste like the lettuce down the road, not the lettuce a million miles away.
Bear Burger tastes better naturally. Bear Burger tastes better naturally.